Hello students, I am Ritika Vajpayee, assistant professor at Texas Institute of Planning and Management. In the lecture series of business environment and legal aspects of the business, today we will cover the globalization and international forces in the business, right? As we have already covered the liberalization and the privatization in LPG series, today we will cover the globalization. Okay, so let's begin with the globalization. Globalization is what? It is nothing but the free movement of the goods, services and the people across the world in a seamless and integrated manner, right? Globalization can be thought of to be the result of the opening of the global economy and the related increase in the trade between the nations, okay? When there is no restriction or no boundaries between the nations, in terms of the trading, in terms of the expansion of the business, this is what? This is globalization. Globalization is, is grounded in the theory of comparative advantage, which states that countries that are, good at, the countries which are good at producing a particular good are better off exporting it to countries that are less efficient at producing that good. So, you can understand this is actually based on the comparative advantage theory, that if one country is good at producing some goods, so they have to export, they have to export these goods to other countries which are actually less efficient in producing that goods. So, in that way, countries can get the comparative advantage and then they can take the help of each other in expansion of the business. So, globalization also means that countries of the world subscribe to the rules and procedures of the WTO, okay? As we have studied in the global environment as well, that we have to follow the rules and regulations and the agreements of the World Trade Organizations. So, in that way, in globalization also means what? We have to follow the procedures, rules, regulations and agreements provided by the WTO, right? Now, let's talk about the stages of globalization, right? Saying every time like being global, being international, being multinational, these phenomena are actually different. These are not having the same meaning. We use all these, all these words very frequently, that that is an MNC, that is a global company, that is multinational, that is international. So, these, we often exchange these words, but actually these phenomena are different, right? First of all, let's start with the domestic stage. Domestic stage is what? The market potential is limited to the home country. Whenever the market potential is limited to the home country, okay? And production and marketing facilities located at home country. This is what? This is domestic stage. जब आप अपने होम कंट्री में ही अपना प्रोडक्शन एंड मार्केटिंग कर रहे हो, अपने होम कंट्री में ही आप अपने कस्टमर्स को टारगेट कर रहे हो, आप जो पूरा एसटीपी है, योर एसटीपी स्ट्रेटजी, दैट ऑल दिस ऑल दिस यू आर ऑपरेटिंग इन योर होम कंट्री ओनली. सो ओके, जस्ट वन थिंग बिफोर द होम कंट्री एंड द होस्ट कंट्री थिंग वी आर डिस्कसिंग, लेट मी डिफाइन व्हाट इज़ होम कंट्री एंड व्हाट इज़ होस्ट कंट्री, राइट? If a company is originated in India, so अगर origin है India, okay, so India is the home country, okay, so if a company is originated in India, so India will be home country for that company. If a company is originated in China, so China will be home country for that, okay. So, the country of origin, we can say the country of origin is known as the home country, right? And all other countries apart from the home country is known as the host country, right? If you are originated in India, you want to expand your business to USA, you want to expand to China, you want to expand to Japan. So, all these countries apart from the India are host country for you, okay? So I hope now the concept of home and host country is clear. Okay, now let's move on to the domestic stage again. So domestic stage is what? When the market potential is limited to home country only and the production and marketing facilities are limited to home country only. This is like you are manufacturing in the home country and you are serving your home country, that is domestic stage. The second stage is international stage. At the international stage, your export increase. The company usually adopts the multi-domestic approach. Okay, that is the international stage. Again, what you have to remember here, international stage means the company is only exporting its products to the host country, right? But it is still manufacturing its products in the home country. Okay, now let's talk about the multinational stage. Marketing and the production facility is located in many countries and more than 1/3 of its sale outside the home countries. Jab kisi bhi organization ki marketing and production facilities ek se zyada countries mein, when they are located in many countries, when you have your marketing as well your production as well as the marketing facilities in home countries and host countries as well. So it means you are at the multinational stage. Okay, and one thing you have to remember with that 1/3 of the sale should be outside the home country. Means total production ka 1/3 aapko host country mein sell karna hai, then only you can say that you are at the multinational stage. Okay, so coming towards the last stage of the globalization, this is known as the global or stateless stage. Okay, the last stage is the global or stateless stage. Making sales and acquiring resources in whatever country offers the best opportunities and lowest cost, ownership, control and top management tend to be dispersed. Ab aise situation aa gayi jahan pe aap उस कंट्री में जाके, उस होस्ट कंट्री में जाके अपना प्रोडक्शन एंड मार्केटिंग फैसिलिटी को सेटअप कर रहे हो जो आपको बेटर फैसिलिटीज़ प्रोवाइड कर रही है, राइट? विच इज़ एक्चुअली प्रोवाइडिंग यू ऑल द अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ एट द लोवेस्ट कॉस्ट. यू हैव द ओनरशिप, यू हैव द कंट्रोल एंड यू नो एवरीथिंग इज़ फेवरेबल. दैट इज़ ग्लोबल स्टेज. कि जिस भी कंट्री में आपको फेवरेबल स्टेजेस दिख रही हैं, आप उस कंट्री में जाके उस होस्ट कंट्री में अपना प्रोडक्शन एंड मार्केटिंग फैसिलिटीज़ को सेटअप कर रहे हो. सो दैट इज़ वॉट, दैट इज़ ग्लोबल स्टेज. सो आई थिंक दीज फोर स्टेजेस ऑफ द ग्लोबलाइजेशन आर क्लियर नाउ. द डोमेस्टिक स्टेज, इंटरनेशनल स्टेज, द मल्टीनेशनल स्टेज एंड द ग्लोबल स्टेज और द स्टेटलेस स्टेज. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टूवर्ड्स द इफेक्ट ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन. सो वेन वी टॉक अबाउट द इफेक्ट ऑफ द ग्लोबलाइजेशन, ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज एक्चुअली हैविंग द पॉजिटिव as well as the negative effects, right? Like every phenomena that we have studied, globalization is also having the positive and negative aspect. Let's talk about the positive effect. The first one is global market. With the globalization, the world becomes a global market, right? So jab world a global market mein convert ho jata hai, ye business ko kaise help karega grow karne mein? If your domestic markets are saturated, right, there is no scope for the marketing, your domestic markets are saturated, you cannot offer something new. So with the help of the global market, this global market can be actually a positive point for you, because now with the help of the global market you will have more population to target. You can make your different positioning strategies, you can offer something new to the new market and the new consumer, right? You can actually grow your customer base with the help of the global market. Next is the cross cultural exchange. You can take the benefit of this cross cultural exchange. There is, with the help of the cross cultural exchange, you can actually with the transfer of the cultures, you can understand the culture of different countries. You can offer something according to that, right? And you can actually incorporate something in your product or your service which is actually from the another culture, right? Next is the foreign trade. Definitely, with the growth of the globalization, the foreign trade also increase, and this this actually helps in the growth of the economy as well, right? Next is competition. So with the growing globalization, the competition also tend to increase, because now with the domestic competitors, you have the global competitors as well. And when you have to compete at international level, when you have to compete at the global level, so you will provide better quality of the products. You will you will continuously update your technology, continuously you will focus on the research and development, you will do something new every day in order to sustain your customer base, in order to increase that as well. Okay, next is the foreign investment. So with the growth of the globalization, you are having a better option of the foreign investment. You can actually offer, you can actually get the help from the other countries, and in the form of the foreign investment, so that the capital problems can be sorted out. There can be, sufficient capital for the expansion of the business, and it also helps in the technology transfer. Okay, the next point is here with the related to the technology. So technology the advanced technology, the positive impact is what the advanced technology. So with the help of the growing globalization, every business can have access to the advanced technology. Not every country is at the developing stage, and not every country has opted the developed stage. So with the mixture of the developing and the domestic and the developed countries, we can actually transfer the technologies with the help of this globalization, and we can actually update in the technology. We can have access to the advanced technologies. Next is a cultural exchange. Definitely, with the growing globalization, there is cultural exchange. Now everything is changing. We are actually, constantly following the culture of other countries. We are trying to understand them. We are trying to adapt them, and we are actually trying to change ourselves according to them, so that we can satisfy the global market. Okay, the next is negative impact. So negative impact kya hai globalization ke? The very first is job insecurity. Like with the growth of the globalization, now there are number of the options, right? For the employment, every company is not restricted to the domestic, to the domestic market only. Now it is having access to the global economy. It is having access to the, all across the world. So it can actually, get a person with the right set of the KSA. KSA stands for what? It stands for the knowledge, skill and the ability. So now every company can have the employee with the particular KSA which is actually required. Okay. So now there are no limitations and no boundations. So it actually, it has actually enhanced the job insecurity. Next is the price fluctuation. There is lot, the price fluctuations are also there with the globalization, as number of the companies are introducing them, every day they are going global, they are collaborating, they are doing the joint ventures and number of the things. So the price fluctuations are also there. Next is the currency fluctuation. With the price fluctuation, the currency fluctuation is also there, because there are number of the global factors which impact, which have impact on the currency fluctuations. The next is neglected agricultural sector. Now everyone is focusing on the technologies and everything, the technology transfer and the advanced technologies, the AI and all. So in that way, somewhere we are actually neglecting the agricultural sector with the growth of the globalization, and it is the negative effect of the globalization. Now let's talk about the marketing entry strategies. When a business decides to go global, there are number of the market entry strategies. Kisi market mein enter karne ke liye bahut sari strategies hain. Hum baat kare agar to sabse pehle we are having the exporting. Exporting is the simplest and the first step of the ladder to enter into the global market. So what is exporting? Exporting can be defined as the marketing of goods produced in one country into the another. आप अपने होम कंट्री में गुड्स को प्रोड्यूस करिए और जब आप उनको होस्ट कंट्री में ऑफर कर रहे हैं दैट इज़ एक्सपोर्टिंग. सिंपल है, आपको प्रोडक्शन स्टार्ट नहीं करना दूसरी कंपनी में, यू जस्ट हैव टू डू योर मार्केटिंग, यू नो, मार्केटिंग फंक्शंस इन अदर कंट्री. द नेक्स्ट वी आर हैविंग द लिस्ट इज फ्रेंचाइजिंग. इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन द फ्रेंचाइजर इज अ सप्लायर हु अलाउज एन ऑपरेटर और अ फ्रेंचाइजी to use the supplier's trademark and distribute the supplier good. Okay, so the players of the franchising business are the franchisor and the franchisee. The franchisor is the person who is actually, you know, allowing the operator to use the trademark and distribute the goods, and franchisee is the person who is actually getting the permission. So we are having a good example is Starbucks. There are number of the example like the MACD, Domino's, number of the examples are present there. The next is licensing. Licensing is defined as the method of foreign operation whereby a firm in one country agrees to permit a company in the another country to use the manufacturing, processing, trademark, know-how or some other skills provided by the licensor. So licensing is a simple phenomena when one company provide license for using the manufacturing, processing or trademark something to the another country which is in the foreign, so that the business can go global. Next is joint venture. Joint venture, an enterprise in which two or more investors share ownership and control over the property rights in the operation. Simple, this is known as what? The joint venture. Okay, now let's talk about the next market entry strategy, that is turnkey contract. Okay, so turnkey contracts are what? These contracts are common in the international business in the supply, erection and commissioning of the plant as the case oil refineries, steel mines, cement, fertilizer plant, etc. Construction project and franchising agreement. Turnkey contract kya hote hain? Bahut hi simple sa concept hai turnkey ka. For example, ek oil refinery ko set up karna hai, theek hai, ek oil refinery set up karni hai. But the owners, those who are actually investing in that oil refinery, cannot prepare the whole refinery by their own. Okay, and ऐसा भी ज़रूरी नहीं है कि जो oil refinery में invest करने जा रहे हैं उनको पता ही हो कि oil refinery को कैसे set up करना है. तो oil refinery को set up करने के लिए जो investors हैं वो एक company को contract देते हैं कि आप हमारे लिए ऑयल रिफाइनरी को सेटअप करिए. ठीक है, हो सकता है ये भी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दें कि लेबर्स को सिखाइए कि काम कैसे करना है. तो ये सारी चीज़ों का जो इनिशियल लेवल पे जो काम होना है, ठीक है, कि रिफाइनरी को सेटअप करना है, ट्रेनिंग देनी है, ये सारे काम के लिए आपने एक कंपनी को अपना प्रोजेक्ट दे दिया जो यही सारे काम करती है. ठीक है, फिर क्या किया उस ABC लिमिटेड जो कंपनी ने कॉन्ट्रैक्ट किया, उसने आपके लिए ऑयल रिफाइनरी तैयार करी, उसने ट्रेनिंग दी वर्कर्स को हायर किया, उनको ट्रेन किया और उसके बाद वो प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट हो गया एंड नाउ यू आर रेडी टू टेक ओवर द चार्ज. दैट इज़ व्हाट? दैट इज़ टर्न की कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग. A company doing international marketing contract with firms in foreign countries to manufacture or assemble while retaining the responsibility of marketing the product is contract manufacturing. Okay, so these are the ways through which any business can enter into the global market. These are the market entry strategies. Okay, now let's talk about the international forces in the business. The very first is role of political environment in the global scenario. So how political environment actually plays a role? The very first is the political system of the business. किसी भी business का political system क्या है, मतलब political system का क्या impact है business पे. The approach of the government towards the business, that is restrictive or facilitating. गवर्नमेंट का क्या अप्रोच है बिजनेस के लिए, रिस्ट्रिक्टिव है, बहुत ज़्यादा रिस्ट्रिक्शंस लगाए हैं, या फिर फैसिलिटेटिंग है, लाइक एक फैसिलिटेटर का रोल प्ले कर रही है गवर्नमेंट facilities and the incentives offered by the government, legal restrictions, for instance licensing requirement, reservation to a specific sector like the public sector, private or the small scale sector, the restrictions on importing technological know-how and capital goods and raw material, the restriction on exporting products and services, restriction on pricing and distribution of goods, and procedural formalities required in setting the business. Okay, so these are all the things which are in the hands of the governments, and government actually plays a role in the global scenario. Now, let's talk about the political environment in the global scenario. So, this is what an economic system to enter the business sector. This must be the economic environment. A stage of economic growth and the pace of growth, level of national and per capita income, you know, the incident of the taxes, both the direct and the indirect taxes, what is the infrastructure facilities which are available in an economy, you know, the availability of the raw material, the component of the cost and thereof, and the sources of the financial resources and their cost, and the availability of the manpower, managerial, technical, and the workers which are available, their salary and their wage structure. So all these things which are related to the economic and political environment combinedly. Okay, now let's talk about the technological environment in the global scenario. So first is the level of technological development in the country as a whole and a specific business sector. So the technological level of development, it actually, you know, it is having the impact on the business sector. The pace of technological changes and the technological obsolescence, kitni jaldi technology change ho rahi hai aur kitni jaldi purani jo aapki existing technology hai wo kitni jaldi obsolete ho rahi hai. This is, you know, also having the impact on the global scenario. Next is the sources of technology, ki jo bhi technology mein changes ho rahe hain wo actually kahan se ho rahe hain, what are the actually sources. Okay, and the restriction and the facilities for technology transfer and time taken for the absorption of the technology. This is what, this is, if you remember, this is technology lag. Okay, सो क्या रिस्ट्रिक्शंस हैं एंड क्या फैसिलिटीज़ हैं टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफ़र के लिए, एंड व्हाट इज़ द टाइम टेकन फॉर द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ द टेक्नोलॉजी. सो ऑल दीज, यू नो, ऑल दीज थिंग्स हैव इम्पैक्ट ऑन द ग्लोबल सिनेरियो. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द रोल ऑफ कल्चरल एनवायरनमेंट इन द ग्लोबल सिनेरियो. So when we talk about the cultural environment, so there are number of the things that we have already discussed in the socio-cultural environment, but still there are points. First is, while analyzing the social and the cultural factors, the organization may consider the following aspect. So kya aspect hai jo consider karne hai organization ko. First is approaches to society toward the business in general and स्पेसिफिक एरिया. तो पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी के क्या अप्रोच है बिजनेस को लेकर और जनरल बिजनेस एरियाज को लेकर, दिस इज एक्चुअली यू नो विच इम्पैक्ट्स द ग्लोबल सिनेरियो. द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द ग्लोब द सोशल कल्चरल एंड द रिलीजियस फैक्टर्स ऑन द एक्सेप्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. जितने भी सोशल कल्चरल या फिर रिलीजन, यू नो, रिलीजियस फैक्टर्स हैं, वो आपके प्रोडक्ट को किस तरह से रिस्पॉन्स देते हैं, क्या एक्चुअली वो आपके प्रोडक्ट को एक्सेप्ट कर रहे हैं और दे आर, यू नो, एक्चुअली बायकॉटिंग, यू नो, दे आर डूइंग बायकॉट ऑफ योर प्रोडक्ट. दिस कैन, यू नो, दिस इज़ एक्चुअली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग टू कंसिडर, अदरवाइज इट कैन, यू नो, क्रिएट अ बिग प्रॉब्लम फॉर द बिजनेस. द लाइफ स्टाइल एंड फॉर दिस, यू नो, सोशल कल्चरल और रिलीजियस फैक्टर आपके प्रोडक्ट्स को हमेशा एक्सेप्ट करें एंड दे ऑलवेज वेलकम योर प्रोडक्ट. इसके लिए ज़रूरी क्या है कि आपको सारे सोशल कल्चरल और रिलीजियस फैक्टर की अंडरस्टैंडिंग होनी चाहिए एंड यू हैव टू, यू नो, डिज़ाइन योर एडवर्टाइजिंग कैंपेन्स, यू हैव टू डिज़ाइन योर मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजीज इन सच अ वे सो दैट, यू नो, इट सपोर्ट्स द कल्चर, द सोसाइटी एंड द रिलीजन इन विच यू आर ऑफरिंग दैट प्रोडक्ट एंड द सर्विसेज. Okay, the next is lifestyle of people and the products used for them. Okay, so what is the lifestyle of the people to which you are, you know, you are offering that particular product and services, and what are the products which are used for them. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड कि अभी किस तरह के प्रोडक्ट्स को यूज़ किया जा रहा है करेंट सोसाइटी के लोगों के थ्रू, और किस तरह के प्रोडक्ट्स उनको ऑफर किए जा रहे हैं. ओके, उसके अकॉर्डिंग ही आपको अपने प्रोडक्ट्स को डिज़ाइन करना है. द लेवल ऑफ द एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंस टू चेंज, तो लेवल ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस क्या है और कितना रेजिस्टेंस टू चेंज है. अगर रेजिस्टेंस टू चेंज हाई होगा सो इन दैट केस ऑल्सो आपके प्रोडक्ट का एक्सेप्टेंस होने में प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट होगा. नेक्स्ट इज वैल्यू अटैच टू अ पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट, दैट इज द प्रोसेसिव वैल्यू और द फंक्शनल वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट, द डिमांड फॉर द स्पेसिफिक प्रोडक्ट्स फॉर स्पेसिफिक ओकेजन एंड द प्रोपेंसिटी टू कंज्यूम एंड टू सेव. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द मेन एस्पेक्ट ऑफ कंसिडरेशन इन इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस. द वेरी फर्स्ट इज अलाइनमेंट ऑफ लोकल इकोनॉमीज विद द ग्लोबल, अलाइनमेंट ऑफ लोकल इकोनॉमी विद द ग्लोबल इकोनॉमी थ्रू फ्री ट्रेड. कितना अलाइनमेंट है लोकल और ग्लोबल इकोनॉमी में, ठीक है, फ्री ट्रेड के एस्पेक्ट में कितना सपोर्ट करते हैं और कितना बेटर कोऑर्डिनेशन है. एंड सेकंड इज एफडीआई फ्लो, फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट का फ्लो कितना है. लाइक ये अगेन डिपेंड करता है कि आपका इकोनॉमिक सिस्टम और आपका जो गवर्नमेंट है उसने कितना परसेंट एफडीआई फॉरेन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट को अलाउ कर रखा है हर सेक्टर में, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट इज द फ्लो ऑफ कैपिटल एंड अलॉन्ग यू नो अंडर दिस द सोर्सेज ऑफ द कैपिटल विल ऑल्सो यू नो वी हैव टू कंसिडर. सेकेंड इज टेक्नोलॉजिकल एडवांसमेंट. नेक्स्ट इज द ईजियर ग्लोबल कम्युनिकेशन, कि कितना ईजी ग्लोबल कम्युनिकेशन कितना ईजी है. अगर कम्युनिकेशन ईजी नहीं है ग्लोबल लेवल पे सो दैट विल बी अ नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट फॉर द बिजनेस. शेयरिंग कल्चरल वैल्यूज एंड द कम्पटिटिव एडवांटेज थ्रू ईजी एसेस टू लो कॉस्ट मटीरियल एंड द लेबर. सो इफ यू हैव द एसेस टू द लो कॉस्ट मटीरियल एंड यू नो द लो कॉस्ट लेबर सो दैट कैन बी द कम्पटिटिव एडवांटेज फॉर योर बिजनेस. एंड द इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी, सो कितनी इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलती हैं अवेलेबल हैं आपके आपके इकोनॉमी में, दैट ऑल्सो यू नो अ मेन कंसिडरेशन फॉर द बिजनेस. ओके, सो हेयर आर द रेफरेंसेज दैट आई हैव यूज टू प्रिपेयर दीज स्लाइड्स. इन दैट वे वी हैव कवर्ड यू नो ऑल द टॉपिक्स विच आर गिवन इन द यूनिट 2. होप दिस विल हेल्प यू ऑल इन योर स्टडीज. थैंक यू ऑल.